They sold out dates, part two. Why is his shit so low? That nigga sound like he in the back of the studio. Like, they was like, yo, Trav, can I get in the joint? He was like way back here trying to fucking record his thing. Like, why does he sound like he's not even in the booth, bro? Alright, so what is good, everybody, on YouTube? This is, of course, your boy B, Bullet RC, coming to you guys again with yet a video. And today, I've been holding off, I haven't been listening to it. Trust me, everybody's been trying to get me to listen to it. Even the stores have been shopping. If you don't know, I'm in NY right now. That's why we got the hotel set up. But I got YouTube loaded up, Astroworld on Genius, so I can check like the features and whatnot. And it's time, bro. It's time for Astroworld. I thought it was never gonna drop. Then out of nowhere, Mike Dean says August 3rd. Travis confirms August 3rd. And now we're here on August 5th. Is it 4th? Today's the 4th, isn't it?
No, 4th.
It is the 4th. August 4th. So listen, man. Let's stop talking. Let's get right into it. Astroworld 2018. There's a lot of hype on this shit. I'm not going to lie to you. This is a first track, Stargazing. My man, Oscar's in the back. So he's got me asking what his favorites is and shit. Beats good so far. Intro track. I gotta listen to this whole thing because I feel like it's not catching me yet. I don't know. Maybe I need my headphones on. I mean, he said watch the switch up. I mean, it's alright so far. Remember, this is just a first like listen reaction off my laptop speakers, bro. I can't hear everything. I like this flow. I like that flow. I feel like this track is gonna be like sweet sweet for me, because I like sweet sweet, and then it took me a while and I started liking it more. Is this what you're talking about? Okay, all right said wait for a switch up. I'm waiting for it. The laptop speakers, I feel like not doing any justice right now, but I'm pretty sure it's gonna sound a lot better in the whip or some headphones. The build-up is crazy right now. Is this still the same song? Where'd this come from? Yo, I can't turn it up. I want to turn it up. This shit's always maxed out. Okay, hold on. We still got a minute left. All right, I see what you're talking about. So that All Right shit, that reminds me of like Cudi on Cudi's album. I don't know if that's Cudi doing it, but that reminds me of like Cudi. Stargazing, track one. I was lukewarm at the beginning. Okay, I was just kind of like, okay, this is cool. When the beat came in, it switched it up. I like that track. Once again, this is my first reaction, bro. Trust me, I guarantee you in a week after I played this album and burnt it out on my iPhone, I'll like it a lot more. But right now, especially when that beat switches up, homie O was right. He said, just wait. Just wait on it, okay? So let's hop into number two, and this one is Carousel, I believe. This has Frank Ocean on it. Maybe I should check. I'm gonna check the features after the song is done, cause that kind of I wouldn't have known. What song is? I heard that before on a song. I tried. Okay, I like this one. Yeah, I need to hear this one. This one right here, I need to hear in the whip for sure. Is Frank rapping or singing on this one? Is he singing? Okay. Yeah, this one. I like this one like right off the rip. This shit's fire, bro. I'm sorry. I'm listening to it right now and like, I'm trying to absorb all of it. This shit is fire already. I'm sorry. Y'all know I'm kind of Travis Scott biased. But I didn't even listen to this in my, like I said, I didn't even listen to this in the whip yet. I'm only on track two. Maybe I should relax. I'm only on track two. It's like set, what, 17, 18 on this joint? 17. Still got 15 more tracks of this. I don't want a Hyundai, bro. I'm trying to listen to Astroworld. I'm sorry. So, track two, Carousel, with Frank Ocean. That one was hot. Like, I liked that song straight off rip as soon as it started coming on. So, that one was good. Once again, these are quick reactions. I need to listen to that one again. I would replay it right now, but I want to go just straight through. So next one, I couldn't avoid. It's Sicko Mode. I know Drake's on it because everybody posted it. I seen academics going wild on camera. Hopefully that was a troll, bro. You got relaxed, though. That was too much. Anyways, Sicko Mode right here. This is probably the hottest track right now on the whole thing as far as buzz go. I mean, once you put Drake on a track, I guess it just skyrockets. So, yo, that clip with Ack when this shit came on. Ooh, okay.
At the gate outside, when they pull up, they give me loose. Yeah,
I like that break. Another beat switch up. Is that three beat switch ups already? Oh yeah. This shit. One thing I will say that's fucking hilarious about Drake to me is his ad-libs. His like whisper ad-libs to himself. Crept through the night. Yeah, yeah. Night. Yeah, yeah. I'm sorry. I had to comment on, bro. It's just one of those funny things about Drake, bro. Number two on trending right now, Sicko. Nah, I fuck with that one, but I do want to check to see who's actually on it. That one was hard. Next up, we got RIP DJ Screw. Yo, I like the beat already. Off rip. Yeah, the beat is hot. They knew the beat was hot too, because it's almost a minute to the song. We ain't heard nothing yet. Is this Swae Lee again? Let me see. I could be wrong, or Nav or something. Nah, Swae Lee. Swae Lee, I was right. Now the beat is real pretty. I really like it. Okay, is he? Okay, there we go. I was about to say, where's Trav at though? This is like I'm in Miami. I just ran a really expensive car that I really can't afford. I throw this on, I'm on South Beach. That's what this sounds like to me. I mean, the song's so fire, it made me regret not getting the shirt. There you go. Like, that's how I'm feeling right now. RIP Screw. Maybe, I mean, it's not fast, but I think the beat, that might be my favorite so far. Next up though, at number five, we have Stop Trying to Be God with Kid Cudi on the track. I don't know if there's anybody else on there, but Kid Cudi. I'm excited to say the least. So if it's not good, I'm gonna be pretty hurt. I mean, we got the Kid Cudi hums. We got somebody else on it. I mean, it's good so far. It's good so far. See, like songs like this, obviously I feel like the lyrics have some meaning to them. So like me listening to it like this, I'm not gonna get it off rip. So I'm trying though. Is this fucking James Blake on this shit? A lot of y'all probably don't really know, but I actually do really like James Blake. That makes the song even more fire, even though I gotta re-listen to it again. But Cudi, Travis, and James Blake. I mean, some of y'all probably heard James Blake came on like, who the fuck is this nigga? But trust me. Stop Trying to Be God, number five. Cudi, Travis, James Blake. Y'all don't need me to tell you that it's fire. I need to listen to it again. But for right now, I'm going ahead and go to the next track, No Bystanders. I'm expecting this one to be a hype song though. Listen. When this comes on, if you at the concert, bruh, this shit's gonna be wild. So that was No Bystanders. I think that's number six. So Juice WRLD and Sheck West was on that joint. That's why the bitch was so familiar.
Yeah.
I was like, that sounds familiar.
I was like, wow. I mean, I was a little bit upset because I wanted more Sheck on it.
Yeah. So that bitch ad-lib is from Death to Draco. If you never heard that from Sheck West, that's a hard song. You heard that song before? Skeletons. Next up. Okay, so this one, they definitely played. When I was shopping in BBC, they definitely played this one. So with this one, I really like the beat. It kind of reminds me of like a Western, honestly, like some rodeo type shit. Just the way it sounds. That's The Weeknd. That was easy. That was an easy feature for me to catch with The Weeknd. All right, so that was Skeletons. I honestly thought that was gonna be a way longer song the way it came on. And so I looked back at the last time, I was literally like, oh yeah, it's 2 minutes, 30 seconds. I mean, The Weeknd and Travis. I mean, it sounds good. I just wish there was more of that track. I mean, there's a lot of like albums coming out with a million songs. This one I was kind of worried about too because it has 17 songs. I thought that was kind of a lot. But so far I've liked all of them. And like sometimes people put 25, 30 songs in their joint and you only be liking like five of them. All the rest is just straight up filler. So this one so far, it don't really feel like filler to me. It feel good. So next up we got Wake Up. That last one had Weeknd on it. If it had somebody else, I missed it. Is more Weeknd? Okay, there you go. I was asking for more Weeknd and then next song comes on. Okay. So this one I can already tell a lot of people gonna fuck with it. I'm not fully in on it yet, but it's sounding good. I'll be excited for this beat switch up, but it's only, what, 10 seconds left? Maybe it'll play into the next one, I don't know. It sounds good. It sounds good, but it's just, I know it's about to end, bro. I know it's about to be over. Blam. Okay. That was Wake Up with The Weeknd. I asked for more Weeknd. More Weeknd on the next track. I gotta listen to that one again. I liked it when it began, and I like some elements of the song, but once again, that one's not pulling me like some of the previous ones we already listened to. So the next track we got is 5% 10. Osa, that's his possible favorite right now. So let me go ahead and, oh, I only had to do it. YouTube did it for me. So there's like a bass in the back that this is not doing any justice to, but trust me, I'm pretty sure. Yeah, this joint in the car, my God. Oh, he did. Okay, so sounds like it might be another beat. Switch up. This time we got like a minute left in the song, so something could actually happen, or we could just ride out. Either way, I'm fucking with 5% tent. This is kind of, this is pretty hard. And that's a wrap, 5% tent. That one was hard. That was hard. I really like the beat. It just sounds dark. It's like underneath, the bass is underneath. I don't know. That one I'm really fucking with. The next one's called NC17. Now, I told O before we started, I hope that this song is hard because it sounds like it should be a hard song. NC17, like what the fuck is that? So it should be a hard song. I'm really hoping it is. All right, NC17, let's listen to this one. Ooh, does it have Cardi on it? It doesn't? Is he ad-libbing? It sounds like his ad-lib is there. Is that Thug? No, it's not? Oh, it's still him. Yo, this nigga is like, he's got everybody's ad-libs down. Oh, okay, 21, okay. Yo, I don't know how Travis did it, but he basically got everybody's ad-libs. Cardi might not be on the track, but his ad-lib is there. Okay, so NC17, got 21 Savage on it. Travis doing his best Playboi Carti impression, if that's not Carti. Him also doing his best Thug impression, if that's not Thug on it. I fuck with that one. I'm glad it's hard because I just, NC17, it has to be hard. Next one is Astro Thunder, another one. I mean, the title, it has to be hard. It's 2 minutes, 25 seconds. I'm assuming it's gonna be faster. We gonna see though, it might not be. So that was Astro Thunder. I feel like probably after some more listens, I'll like that one, but right off the bat, not really one of my favorites. And once again, bro, this sun is playing with me. I had to keep changing my settings, but that was that. The next one up is Yosemite is the next one. So let me go ahead and peep that joint real quick. Yosemite, 2 minutes and 32 seconds, another quick one. Oh, this is the one I was telling you about. This shit, okay, hold on. Before we start this, I heard this one a little bit too when I was shopping. This shit sounds like Sold Out Dates. Maybe I'm wildin', but this shit sounds like Sold Out Dates to me. Yeah. Well, actually, is this Gunna on this? Okay, so this track has Nav and Gunna. So this must've been a real easy song for Gunna to do. Sold Out Dates, I'm on that. This is the same shit. It's Sold Out Dates, part two. Why is his shit so low? That nigga sound like he in the back of the studio. Like, they was like, yo, Trav, can I get in the joint? He was like way back here trying to fucking record his thing. Like, why does he sound like he's not even in the booth, bro? What the fuck was Nav doing on that track? I mean, it's not even like, I don't even know if it was good or not. The only thing I can focus on how fucking low this nigga was in the back of the fucking booth. Yosemite. It's a hot track. It sounds just like Sold Out Dates. Sold Out Dates is a hot track. It has Gunna on, so I guess it is what it is. Next up is Can't Say. Nav is on that one too. That's all I can really say about that. So I definitely heard this one while I was shopping too. Some of it at least. Okay, is that actually Young Thug? He's not on the album. Young Thug is not on here. Don Toliver. I've never heard of him. But hey, salutes on the Trap album. This one. This one's all right. This might be my least favorite so far. Okay, so Can't Say. Sorry, yes, I did skip through that one. Not one of my favorites. Not one of my favorites. I'm not gonna say it's bad, just not one of my favorites. Next one is Who What? And we're definitely skipping the fuck out of Butterfly Effect. I'm fucking with the beat on this one. Hold on. Oh no, it's not. I was about to say it's Quavo, but he's not. Yes, he is, actually. Sorry, I was right. This is way better than that last track. Like, it's picked me back up. So, Who What featuring most of the Migos, 2 out of 3. That one was hard. I like that track. It's way better than the last one. It definitely brought me back up. So, the next one is Butterfly Effect. And like I said, we are skipping the fuck out of that because we've heard that 1,000,001 times. So, next up is Houston Fornication. So this is another track off the album that I feel like, it sounds good now, but I feel like this might be another one, like, I'm trying to think of songs that I listened to, like, after a while, really, like, built on me, like, Sweet Sweet is a good example of a song that I didn't really listen to a lot, and I listened to it again and kept listening to it. So I feel like this one might be one of those, honestly. Oh, he was on that next track. Mm, I didn't even hear Pharrell on that one, to be honest with you. I'm re-listening, trust me, after I get done with this video, I'm gonna listen to it again. We're an hour in recording. My time says 1 hour and 2 minutes, but we are at the last song, which is Coffee Bean. I'm going to assume it's like a more chill track to send out the album. You said what? It's different, okay. Yeah, this does sound like, if this song came on, I wouldn't think that Travis would be on it. So this one so far, like, I mean, it is different. It's like a little bit more laid back, a different type of beat that than Travis, I think, would usually be on, in my opinion. But I don't know, it sounds good. Like, as an album ender, I feel like this is the right vibe. This is the right mood. But let me go ahead and finish the track first. Honestly, this reminds me of 808s. This particular piece reminds me like 808s and Heartbreaks. That's what this sounds like to me. And that was it. 2018, August 4th. We just got Astroworld. That was my first time listening to it. Y'all kind of heard me talk about it. You know, I like the album, but what I want to do right now is listen to the album a lot more rather than just one quick reaction. So I can't really rate it. I don't want to do none of that because, once again, bro, it's a quick reaction. If I had to pick out a favorite real quick, let me see. 5% 10. That was kind of hard. I like R.I.P. Screw. I mean, Yosemite is, like I said, it's the same fucking song as Sold Out Day. So I can't put that one up there. So I'm saying right now, I mean, 5% 10 is good. And Stargazing, when it switches, it's good. Sicko Mode is hard. The whole thing is fucking hard, basically. So that's it. That's my reaction to Astroworld. 1 hour and 7 minutes on the clock on my camera. I got 9 minutes left on my card. That's it though. I hope you guys enjoyed. Listen, y'all let me know, whatever your favorite track was, leave that down below. Astroworld is here in full effect. The Travis Scott stan is here. And just to let y'all know, the homie DP, as I'm finishing this last song, just text me and ask me that I still need the Travis Scott's for retail. I'm gonna leave y'all on that. That's it. I'm out. Peace.